we have seen the rivers depleting, but then you set yourself the target, how can we mobilize people to be engaged with this? What was your thinking?
When we started this project GreenHands to plant trees, I made a simple process that because this is a spiritual moment, we had large following. Because this is a very eclectic group of people, non-religious spiritual movement, handling spiritual process as a science, as a technology for your well-being. So I started this movement making people breathe with the trees and make them experientially see that what you exhale the trees are inhaling and what the trees are exhaling you're inhaling. So literally one half of your breathing apparatus are hanging out there on the trees. Once we made people experience this, now I can't stop them from planting trees. Everybody's just going wild. Wherever they can, they're planting trees and everybody wants to plant trees. So many movements, hundreds of movements have started across Tamil Nadu, many, many organizations. And when we set up a Guinness record of planting the maximum number of trees in a day, I saw such a healthy this thing happening that at least another 20 to 27 organizations desperately trying to break that record. I thought that's really great that such things began to happen. One thing I realized was individually whatever we do, as organizations whatever we do is not enough. We need a government policy, we need a long-term policy which will determine how we use our natural resources, particularly rivers and forests and soil. These three things, how this should be managed. So we are looking at how to make the soil and water, particularly rivers and forests, as a national treasure, not as something that everybody can use whichever way they want.